My name is Ashish, and today I'm going to talk about the power of an idea. The talk will revolve around how one idea can change the rest of our lives. And to say this, it brings me great pride that 3 years ago, with the first TEDxSMIT, I was in the fourth row as a student, and today I'm here thanks to an idea. And that's how powerful an idea is. I pursued an idea to make our roads more energy efficient and safer for people. And since the last 3 years, that's one idea that I have been pursuing. And my learnings are two, which I wanted to share with all of you. That these two key principles allowed me to pursue it for the last 3 years and allowed me to really understand what is this power that is there in this one idea. And these two things are patience and perseverance. These two things enabled in understanding how we convert an idea and make it to reality. Right? So, basically about me, I'm not here to talk about me, I'm here to talk about you. I'm going to talk to you today, and this is how it all started, just to share. I want to talk to you about the last 3 years of failing multiple times, and across my life, how many times I failed, and what I learned, mostly in these 3 years of pursuing one idea. Still a little nervous. So when we look at life, everybody tells us that life is simple. Make it life. Life is simple. Live a life which is simple. It's just going through the ups and downs. You know, unfortunately, it's not as simple as plotting something in a simple graph and saying you're going through the ups and downs of life. It's not true. Life is complex. In reality, life is complex. These are all different spheres of our lives. This is the same wave. It's a simple sine wave, but in different forms, in different ways, different spheres of our lives. It could be family, career, relationships, and all of these are in emotional turbulence, right? All of them are basically at different points of time how we feel. Reason why we need to think that it's not the end of the world when you start failing. It means that you started learning new things and more often. So one thing that I realized in these 3 years is when you're succeeding, when you're in the ups of your time, prepare for the downs. How bad can it be? And when you start preparing for the downs and the ups, when the downs come, you actually don't feel the roughness of the downs. Right. So in this, even before we start thinking about an idea, fear grips us. It holds us back, stopping you to move. Fear is supposed to drive you. And if you start seeing fear as a driver behind you, that, okay, fear is there, what do I need to do to get this fear out of my mind? Once you start thinking of fear like a button, red button, keep pressing that one button like this, keep pressing that one button till you stop seeing that button. I believe in fighting with situations because that helps us to increase our patience and perseverance. Every time I felt that things cannot move forward, things cannot go forward, I kept this one thing in mind that I just need to sleep for, I need to survive one night. I need to sleep one night and tomorrow morning, it's going to be a new dawn, new day, and I'm going to fight again. And one very interesting sentence that I really liked which helped is, too much analysis leads to paralysis. When we think too much about fear, that fear is there, the fear is there, that's going to kill me, that's going to, you will just paralyze, and fear will definitely kill you. But start thinking like this, am I analyzing the situation too much? As he said, the ship that went to save Titanic, he did not think about it. Let's do it. We'll figure it out on the way. Similarly, figure out how you're going to get over your fear on the way. Following one idea across life, multiple things tried, never really pursued it till the end. But this one thing I decided, I'm going to leave it no matter what, I will pursue it, and I really learned something out of this, which I thought would be really useful. When we start thinking about an idea, we go to people, we talk to people, we try taking advice, we try taking guidance from them, and sometimes we either get appreciated or we get shot down. And when we get shot down, we feel upset about it and leave the idea. I've realized that we forget that when we talk about the idea that we have, we forget that there is something called as background. When we talk to someone about an idea which is about solving cancer, and we go and talk to someone who is not at all close to what we want to do, he may not be having any context or any background to really give you the right feedback. Taking the right feedback is the most crucial idea, the most crucial learning that that I took away. And the power of one. You know, energy is something that is not finite. We think it's infinite, but it is finite for human being. If we divide our energy in multiple directions, in multiple ideas, multiple goals, we reach nowhere. But if we divide it only by one, we reach further. Example, maybe it doesn't connect well just by a diagram, but imagine I tell you, go and fight four people alone. You will say, it's not possible. If you're really brave, you might say yes. But normally, people will say no. But if I tell you fight one guy, you say, I can try. That's how we know physical strength is easily perceivable, but energy of a human mind or a human body, it cannot be measured or quantified, so you can't perceive it. But when you divide it, you reach nowhere. But if you keep it focused, you still can. Multiple goals in our minds creates stress. And perseverance is similar to a muscle. Like we go to bodybuilding, gymming, we build our muscles. Similarly, perseverance is a muscle here. When we take decisions, perseverance is a muscle that gets used again and again and again. And if we have to take decisions on hundreds of things that we're thinking and dreaming about, it becomes for our muscle difficult to handle that. So it is very, very important that we have one goal and pursue it doggedly. That allows perseverance to actually manage itself and be patient. Patience. I used to find this word really confusing when I was a kid. Whenever I would go somewhere and I would be jumping around, my mother would say, Ashish, be patient, sit here. I didn't know what patient means. Being sitting there is patience, waiting there is patience. What to do? Is patience an activity? Is it a verb? What exactly? Be patient means, am I doing something? No, you're not supposed to do something. You know, you can't jump around, you can't play. But during these 3 years, I realized what patience is. When we go from one place to another place, we will go from A to B, definitely. But what we do basically during this journey from A to B, and how we are doing that we wanted and given us the passion for our lives, that's where dominoes play a really important thing. If you have a small domino, 2 inches in size, and the next domino 50% larger, by the time you reach 51st tile, it is as big as Mount Everest. That is the power of doing small things continuously, and finally you have a big goal that you achieve. Celebrating each win. After starting small, there are going to be small achievements that you do in this way. Celebrate each moment, because when you're going through the up and down, the downs actually enable you to look back and see, I went through a tougher time and that's what I did. So if you don't celebrate, you somehow forget about what you've done. So having the celebrations, the moments, relish them. Enjoy it with your family, friends. And that what gives us power. And that's the power of an idea which gets enabled by these small moments slowly building up. is in today's generation, as our directors have quoted, everything is about fast, quick. It takes time to mold, right? And it takes time to understand how to prioritize also. It took me time. In 1990s, when computers became popular, a new word came into our dictionary, which is called multitasking. Priorities. We did not have these words before the computers came. Because computers could do one task and switch to the next task without even bothering what really happened in the previous task. But humans don't work that way, because computers think only from here. Humans think from both here and here. All our decisions, thoughts, and actions are driven by both. Whereas computers just think here, so they switch to the new task. So having one priority as a human being versus comparing yourself to a computer which is i7 or whatever is not possible. You can't multitask. Just have one idea, one goal, pursue it to a point where you're confident about it. Green Berets. My inspiration for today's talk is Green Berets. They are the special forces of United US Army, and the 0.01% people who apply for it finally make it to a commando. And what they believe in is improve, adapt, and improvise. And today, we are here all to talk about audacity to mold. So with this, all I want to say is, it's all about taking the small steps that you have in this journey. Enjoy all of them. And be patient and be perseverance. Thank you.